Hello students, now today we will study the periodicity and properties of S block. S block elements are the reactive and reducing metals, so their periodicity and properties are very important, because by the study of this we can predict that these metals are used in catalysts in various reactions. These metals are also used in solvents as solvent intermediates used for various purposes in synthesis. These active metals also used in the devices, solar cells, like potassium is used. These metals are present in biological fluids, cells of animals and plants, for example sodium, calcium, magnesium, that are present. And these S block also consist of some radioactive elements like francium from first day, radium from second day. So here we have to study periodicity and properties of these S block metals. First A group have the general configuration NS1, second A group have general configuration NS2. So here first A group elements are alkali metals, second A group elements are the alkaline earth metals. Hydrogen is present in first A in the first period, but it is removed from modern periodic table, kept apart, because it is a gaseous element. Actually, metal starts, the series starts given by Mendeleev modern periodic table, that is after Moseley, that is lithium atomic number 3 having configuration 3s1. Next sodium is there in first alkali metals, atomic number 11 configuration 3s1, potassium 19 4s1, rubidium 37 5s1, cesium 55 6s1, francium 7s1 1, but this valence configuration with radioactivity, it is a radioactive element. In second A group, here it starts with the second period after lithium, beryllium 4, 2s2. In next third period after sodium, magnesium is there. Atomic number 12, 3s2 configuration. Calcium 24s2, strontium 38, 5s2, barium 56, 6s2. Here also, last element from 7th period, that is radium, it is radioactive in alkaline earth metals. These are earth crust metals, these are helios or sea derived or air derived elements. Some occurs in sea. So here, what is a periodic trend? We study their atomic sizes, oxidation states, the ionization potentials, energies, electron affinities, electronegativities. That are the periodic trends on which their compound formation property depends. Also, we'll study their physical and chemical properties here. As hydrogen is gaseous, it is kept apart. After that, actually metal starts. These are reducing metals from first and second A group. All are reducing means they consist one or two electrons that can be released. So they shows oxidation states as positive 1 for alkali metals, plus 2 for alkaline earth metals, means positive 2 oxidation state shown by these alkaline earth metals. These 2 electrons can be released, here 1 electrons can be released. So these forms single cations, these forms divalent cations. So these are their oxidation states and oxidation potentials. They have positive oxidation potentials because these are reducing metals used in catalysis in various reactions. So what is periodicity? From top to bottom along the group, the atomic sizes, you know that as shells increases from hydrogen to francium, cesium, francium, the atomic sizes increases. Actually, these metals are very big sized metals, because what is the periodic trend? Along the period from left to right in periodic table, atomic sizes are going on decreasing. So these metals have bigger sizes, alkaline earth metals, also alkali metals with higher size, bigger atomic sizes. So their ions will also consist of big sizes, hence they are reducing, they are reactive metals. So from top to bottom, sizes increases from left to right, first A to second A group, atomic ionic sizes decreases. as these are big size elements, metals, so they are releasing the electrons. They have higher electron affinities or lower electron affinities? Yes, as these are releasing, they are lower having electron affinities. They are having low ionization energies, means they easily releases electrons. So ionization energies are low, their electron affinities are also low, so they have electropositivity. These are electropositive elements, means whenever heat is supplied, they show some flame colors by release of electrons. When energy is given to molten state of these elements, electricity is given, they can conduct. They conduct very good amount. They can form salts, they can form hydroxides easily because they combine with negative ions, halides and oxidants. So on the which this periodicity, the physical and chemical properties of these reactive reducing metals depends. So let's study the physical and chemical properties of these elements, because after periodicity we must study, or we have to study their physical and chemical properties. As we see towards these elements, as we see from first day to second day, these elements are reducing and reactive, containing 1 to 2 electron. We have to study their physical and chemical properties, because after knowing the physical and chemical properties, we can understand easily their reactivities.